Hello everyone, I'm Jonty and I have some bad news. This is the end of the event. I know. It's bad news for you, it's really good news for me. I can't tell you how excited I am to go home to my bed. But anyway, this is it. Apart from, we do have some stuff in Null Sector. There is still music performances, there's still things going on. So it's not completely done, but this is the last talk. And it's not even really a talk, it's just me rambling at you, but here we are. Anyway, we really hope that you've enjoyed this event. I really hope you've enjoyed this event as well, because this has been an extremely hard experience for all of us to put it on. And despite the wind and the rain, it seems like everyone's quite happy. So, I'd like to say sorry to the people who had their tents collapse last night. That's really awful. I'm sorry about that. And there's not a lot we can do, really. But I hope you stuck it out. And I hope everything was OK in the end. And hearing how happy everyone has been around the site has been rejuvenating for all of us. This has been so hard. And the only thing that makes it worthwhile is when you tell us what a good time you're having and the experiences you've had and the friends you've made. And it's absolutely fantastic. And people keep coming up to me and just saying, I've been waiting for this for 4 years. And it's like, so have I, but for different reasons. But I'm really glad that it's been worthwhile for you. And I hope that you're going to want to come back. It's so much work and so much happens behind the scenes. But you will make it worthwhile for us. So thank you. Quick credit thing, this is a light painting. Sorry? Never mind. A quick credit thing, this is a light painting made by the Youth Village, I think yesterday. So we've got one of these from every EMF going back the last three events, I think. So this is a 2022 edition, and I want to show it to you all. So any of the kids who worked on this, excellent work. Do it again next time. Thank you. So let's talk about some numbers. There's been a bunch of numbers in the previous talk, so we're going to give you more numbers because everybody loves numbers in this tent, I'm aware. And some of these are different numbers, so that's okay. Anyway, we have had more talks, more workshops, more music, basically more of everything than we ever have before, somehow with less team members, but you know, it's worked out okay. And I'm really pleased with everything that's happened. I hope everyone actually enjoyed the talks and workshops. I know we've had some AV problems, sorry about that. It's just the way it goes. We're in a field and it's a bit wet, so things go wrong. And this isn't including also all the kids who learned to DJ yesterday for the first time, who then made up their own DJ names, made posters, and did DJ sets in Null Sector earlier on today. I don't know how many people caught that, but it was awesome. So, we've also used 149 meters of Velcro. I don't know where that is. Presumably, a lot of this is held up with Velcro. I'm not sure where. 154 meters of bunting, all of which you're happy to take if you'd like to keep some. We want some for ourselves, but we really don't need 154 meters of bunting. The jellyfish in Null Sector is each little segment is a different circuit board in it. And we have had one offer to buy one of the jellyfish so far. So I don't know if you know if it's for sale, but the second one hasn't been claimed yet. Null Sector has 1,000 3D printed bolts, and every single time I spoke to Charles, who runs Null Sector, for the last year, his 3D printer was running in the background of his call with his 3D printer printing bolts. And he kept just holding up, like, here's another bag of bolts, just ridiculous things. And we also have 1.5 3D printed Diplodocus skulls, which are in the bar. They are Dippy the dinosaur's head from the Natural History Museum, who gave us the scans. What you can't see is that it's 1.5 3D printed dinosaur skulls, there's one complete one and one half one, but they're both missing exactly one part round the back. So if anyone would like to spare some time and has a 3D printer, you've got just enough time to print the remaining part out. So that would be awesome, but you know, we got one complete one. We have one complete dinosaur skull. We've also had an offer from the Natural History Museum to give us the 3D scan of the entirety of Dippy the Dinosaur. To which they said, it's impossible, nobody would do this. And I am taking that as a challenge. So, challenge accepted. Apparently, it's something like 20 meters long. So we've all got quite a lot of work to do over the next 2 years. So, and also, they said, what would you do with it afterwards? To which I said, I don't care. That's your problem. So, anyway, next time. We have issued 2,381 badges. There are still some left. If you have not got your badge, please collect it before you leave camp. I hope the badge tent is open. Apparently, I sent people there too early before on the opening talk, and I might be sending them there too late this time. Let's find out. But we will not post them to you afterwards. It's too much work. So please claim your badge if you can. There we go. We have had 10 tons of chairs that you're all sat on right now. I'm also going to ask you at the end to remove your chairs and move them to the side, because moving 10 tons of chairs is quite hard, and we're not doing it for you. We had 73 items to Lost and Found, including 3 radios, which were not our radios, so well done for that. And apparently the fastest time to reunion for a Lost and Found item was 0 seconds, because the person who handed the item in was handing it in for the person behind them who'd lost it. So. So thank you for being amazing attendees, because every single time people come to the event, they're like, oh, people will steal my things, or they'll get lost. And they say, it doesn't happen. Everyone here is absolutely lovely, and thank you for that. So round of applause for yourselves for just being lovely people. We have had over 100 faxes sent. I don't know where or to what. Absolutely nobody faxed the HQ, and I'm really upset about this. I had one request, so, you know, anyway. We also had 3,419 SIM cards on our temporary phone network, which somehow didn't fall over. So full credit to the phone team for the experimental phone network, which everyone didn't, I think most people didn't even notice that they had phone signal. There is no phone signal here. That was all our doing, apart from when we turned it off. And 16,700 calls on the phone network, and I'm fairly sure about 15,000 of those were me. So, anyway, it all worked perfectly. Thank you to the phone team for that. We have sold a lot of beer. There are no cans left. You drank it all last night, which we're a bit astonished by. We had 106 volunteers in the bar, all of whom were absolutely wonderful and dealt with, frankly, ridiculous bar crew queues all the time. We used 768 meters of receipt paper, which was so much receipt paper that we had to do an emergency order midway through the event, because we were printing so many receipts for beer. So we just got through too much. And also, I found out today that apparently I have the second highest bar tab. So I'm not buying anyone drinks anymore. That was it. I don't know who's got the highest bar tab, but congratulations. Oh, I've got the same slide twice there. And we have raised £4,000 for the Red Cross. And this is all from the Bring and Donate. This is just you dropping off your old rubbish that you didn't want and other people buying it. And I've seen some absolutely marvelous things in there. My absolute favorite thing that happened in the entirety of EMF was walking past the Bring and Donate at some point, and someone was holding a Geiger counter, and I went, is that a Geiger counter? They went, yeah, it's a Geiger counter, but I know I can't really test it. I don't know if it works. And I went, oh, there's a radioactive uranium source just in that tent over there. And someone walking past just burst out laughing. It was absolutely brilliant. So it's, favourite thing that happened. We also had one power outage in Ledbury that nobody noticed, because apparently we still had power and the castle still had power, but nobody else in Ledbury did. So, but it almost took out our internet connection, so our power team were running around desperately putting a new generator in and got it plugged in just in time for the power to come back on. So thanks for that. Sorry it went wrong. We also had one unplanned Tesla coil incident. Which is par for the course, because it also happened in 2018. But also, if you're going to bring a Tesla coil, can you please tell us so we don't put it next to the very expensive things that get fried by Tesla coils? Anyway. Badges. As I already mentioned, you've got your badges, or hopefully you've all got your badges. We will continue to release firmware updates for the badges over the coming weeks. As promised in the opening talk, we will release the update that adds the U2F FIDO security key function in the coming weeks, hopefully sooner rather than later, but we're all very tired, and the badge team, I think, don't want to touch the badges for quite some time now, so we'll see how that goes. It does over-the-air updates, so just connect it to your home Wi-Fi network, and then every now and then check for updates. We will email you when these things come out. There will be post-event emails, not many because we don't want to spam you, but just make sure you update it so you get extra features as they come out later. There's a capture the flag event on site, which, yay! And I'm fairly sure about half the audience are like, I don't even know what that is. I don't know where it is. And to be honest, I didn't see anything about it either, but I've been quite busy. This is essentially a challenge set up, computer security challenge, people are trying to break into stuff. We run it every single year. The team that run it are brilliant. Unfortunately, they keep putting me down as one of the targets for the capture the flag, which I'm not very happy about. I don't know if it happened this year. I haven't found out. But I would like to say congratulations to Grace Hopper's posse, who won with 404 points. So congratulations to them, especially. Especially because that team returned after playing in 2018 where they came third and have got to first this time. So congratulations to you. That's an awesome achievement. Well done. So we need to talk about some serious things, which is all of our team. Now, I actually just realized we haven't done this. Can all the EMF team who are in here right now, who are capable of it, can you all come and sit on the front of the stage right now? It's not, I don't care if it's not big enough. Sit on each other's knees. So, come on, all of you, everyone who's here, don't hide. I think we're going to need a bigger stage. Obviously, the AV team are still at the back, but, you know. Right, so. Can all of the EMF team... I hate these radios. Can all of the EMF team not currently sat on stage A please report to stage A to sit on stage A?
No.
Ooh. Anyway, we'll see if more people show up. Should have done that before, sorry. So... Everyone's out on the stage. This is a fraction of the team. I am just one of the people that make this event happen. All of these people have done different things, both on-site, off-site, and many more of them are still elsewhere on the site, currently working to keep the event happening, to prepare for later, feeding people, still building Null Sector, probably, because we build that until the very end. And this wouldn't happen without all of these wonderful people. And every single one of these people sat on this stage is unpaid. They have bought their own ticket to this event. They are here just the same as you are, but they have put so much time in the months leading up to this, in the years leading up to this in some case. And we need all of them. And we need more people than this. This isn't enough people to do an event of this size. We just about get by with what we have. So in the future, we need you as well. And I know there are people sat in the audience who I've spoken to who've said, I want to be involved in this event. I want to make this happen. And we want you. We want you to help us make this happen again. Because if you don't, it won't happen. We can't keep doing it like we are. We're all burned out. We're tired. But we want to come back. So I want you to give a utterly deafening round of applause for all the people here. I know we did it in the opening, but we're going to do it again. I want it to be so loud that they can hear it at the other end of the field. I don't care if there's nobody there. It's just in case. Yeah, the null sector bar is open and there's people DJing and I want them to hear it and be really annoyed that someone's a bit loud. So, everybody applaud now. Excellent. Hooray! Etc. Anyway, we can do that at the end. Or now. Right. So these people, they made the event happen in the first place and they've run the event during it, but we also couldn't have done it without all the volunteers. All the people who came and volunteered on site. And as I said earlier on, we had, actually I'm not sure if I actually put that in there, we had hundreds of people volunteer for this event. And they did everything from running the bar to keep doing the AV at the back, like people are doing right now. 550-something, that's all we really know. But 550-odd people who did things on-site to keep it going, and we cannot do it without them, it would not work. So, just so we've got a show of hands here, who has volunteered at the event? Can you just raise your hand? Oh, that's some good numbers. Now you applaud these people. Thank you so much for giving up your time during the event. I know there's so much to see and do, and it's hard to try and pull yourself away, but without you doing that, this could not happen. So thank you so much for that. Unfortunately, we need to ask a little bit more of you. We still have to make all of this go away again, and it's quite a lot of things. So we have 4 days to get the event torn down, and there's quite a lot of people who are volunteering to help tear down, but tomorrow morning especially, in fact tomorrow just in general, we have to get all the stages cleared out, we have to get null sector taken down, we have to do all of these things. If you can stay around for tomorrow morning, if you can spend a bit of time just helping move things around, it's not particularly hard work, it's just hard to, in terms of number of people, we would really appreciate your help. All you need to do is hang around and we will put you to work, moving chairs, stacking things, whatever. Please, if you can help, that would be awesome. I don't know if it's even feasible for people to stay longer than that. I know everyone has to get back to work. If you can stay for a few more days, that would be amazing. I'm sorry about the rain. We don't have a weather control machine. I keep asking for one, but no one seems to submit one to the CFP. So, future years. We also have to thank our sponsors briefly, just because without them, we wouldn't have most of the things that we do at on site. We wouldn't have the wonderful childcare. You wouldn't have your badges. We wouldn't be able to pay for speakers who need help to get here. We wouldn't be able to cover tickets to people who can't afford to come otherwise. All of that is, and the live transcription, which is going over there, hopefully, I can't see. All of that is made possible by the sponsors. So thank you to all the sponsors. I know a lot of them are on site. Thank you so much for that. So I mentioned before, we want to come back. We want to come back to this site, hopefully, fingers crossed, we're working on it. But we really do need help. We really do need people to volunteer for the organization. We need people to come on board and work to build the event with us, to build the event months in advance, to do the boring work of emailing people and calling people and generally being quite disappointed when people say no all the time. But we need people to help us do that. We don't have enough people right now, and frankly, a few of the teams this year were on absolute skeleton crews and are for teardown as well. And each of those teams is critical to this event happening. And if we don't get help with them in the future, we cannot run this event. Every single part fits together in the jigsaw, and without one piece, it will fall apart. Please, if you have time and you think you can contribute to this, like, get in touch with us. I promise you it is really fun, and you meet amazing people, and you will do things you thought were impossible. We're frequently told that this is impossible, that this event cannot happen, that you can't ensure that, that actually, why would anyone do that anyway? And people just don't think it's a thing that can happen, and it only happens because we're willing to put the time in, and that people are willing to put the time in to do things that are, frankly, a bit stupid half the time. Like, none of this really makes financial sense, but we do it anyway, and all of you made that happen, and we need your help to do it in the future. So these people, hopefully most of them come back, we can't guarantee it, but if you would like to be stood on this stage looking back at near 1,000 people, feeling quite good about what you've done with your time, come back in 2024, we'd like to have you. And that's honestly about it. We really want to thank all of you for coming. Thank you for supporting us over the years. Thank you for repeatedly coming back from when we were originally started with a bar under a motorway that frankly shouldn't have been there anyway. And you're still here, and I was walking around the site just on my own at 3 o'clock in the morning of the night going, oh my God, what have we done? Like, how is this happening? Thank you for supporting us with this. Thank you for believing that it can work, and thank you for having a good time. We really hope to see you again in 2 years, hopefully. I mean, we'll see after what's happened before. If you see any of these people around the site after this, you see anyone wearing high vis, you see anyone who's doing a shift on the bar or doing something, say thank you to them. Just make sure they feel good for what they've done and the time they've spent. The rest of the evening, there is still content on. There is music on stage. B, I can never remember this. B for bands, C for cinema, I know. Oh, there are films. I genuinely didn't know there was film. There's films. There's films, and Null Sector will be open until 1, is that right? 1 or 12? Until midnight. The bar must be drunk dry. Please don't leave us with all the beer, because we'll have to drink it. And the flamethrowers must use all the propane, so we'll be using all of that as well. I don't have any propane statistics, sorry, someone did ask, so I don't know how much we have. 100 kilos. We have 100 kilos of propane left to burn, so there'll be quite a lot of flames. And that is absolutely everything. Thank you so much for coming. I hope you had a wonderful event. My final request is that when you leave this tent, please pick up your chair and stack it at the side over here.
There's a pallet outside.
Oh, stack it on the pallets outside. We're much more organized this year. I actually have one final thing I didn't put into my slide deck, and I want to just call it out quickly here. Some people will have noticed that people called out our speaker diversity issues on the sign outside. We absolutely hear that, and we want to address it, and we will do our best for that. Thank you for calling out. Thank you for holding us to account. It means a lot to us, and we will do our best to make that better for next time.